This is now diving a little bit into the smart sensor topic here. So first of all here, I think it's important to also, when I say smart sensors, what it is, yeah, what do I actually mean? So what is the definition? Let's take a look on a conventional sensor. So a conventional sensor is a device that can take a physical property and convert this into some measurable electrical signal. But this alone is not enough to call it a smart sensor, of course. So we need to be able to do more. I have a very basic figure here to the right here that shows some of the architecture or some of the building blocks that needs to be in place before you can start to talk about a smart sensor platform. On the bottom here, you can see a base sensor. So of course, there needs to be some kind of sensing element, sensing that device that can take this physical happening and turn this into to a measurable signal. But then again here, it will be fed into a microprocessor platform, which is a huge or a very important part of the smart sensor topic, you could say. Because you need, in order to be smart, you need to have computational power embedded in the sensor. So basically an internal computer system. We talk about internal memory where we can store information and handle information in different ways. And then also a very crucial element, that's the communication module. So you need some communication interface in order to get the access to the smartness, basically, right? Or in order to pass on some of the new values you can build up inside the sensor and get them out to the customer interface. So that's why customer communication module is super important. As shown here, we talk about the data in and data out. But again, depending on protocol, could also only be data out, right? I have some examples here. What kind of new features do we talk about, right? And just to very low level here, this could be information about on the diagnostic side. So what has the sensor experienced over lifetime, for instance? So some self-assessment logics that can also be very beneficial in case of problems on the application side. Self-calibration features, so maybe application-specific, installation point-specific algorithms that will trigger certain calibration steps. Multi-sensing is super important or interesting, where you look into a sensor that can even that can detect more than actually one physical property, and this could be a combined pressure, temperature, humidity, gas sensing, you name it, right? So sensors that can handle more sensing elements, basically. Digital processing, like I already said, so now we have data flowing in. We can maybe combine data in a smart way if we talk for multiple sensors and so on, but also really squeezing out value now or storing relevant data in a memory that can be accessible to the customer. And also, of course, to perform the data conversion to fit to whatever communication module or protocol you have on the application side.
Yeah, and we have a really good question, Dennis, coming from Trevor Michael. Would the smart sensor solution not be a lot more expensive than the conventional ones? That's really a good question.
Yeah, that's a good point. So maybe I should actually have had this as the introduction to the slide here. But because, you know, this is not something new that you have computational power inside a sensor and that you have embedded communication modules. So you had this for more than one decade, right? But we are used to know those kind of building blocks from the more process transmitter industry. So from the chemical industry, medical industry, and so on, where we talk about really, really expensive solutions. So 1,000 euro per sensor and then even higher prices in some cases. And this is, of course, not what we are talking about here. So what we are talking about is now actually to take benefit of new technologies and also the scale on some of the components here. So we actually can embed those things now in our solutions and our products and still have focus on a low cost device. So now suddenly making all this also relevant for more standard and low cost sensors. So this is the whole logic behind this. To utilize technology development and to really bring out some of those features and values also now down to those sensors here. I hope that was answer.